Facial recognition, whether we like it or not, it's here to stay. And it's here to stay because it's a tool that can be used by a number of different agencies and or businesses to ensure safety or to minimise risk to people. The key aspect of what we need to look at now is how can we improve the privacy around the use of this technology to ensure that we're not breaching people's rights beyond what they should be breached. Artificial intelligence has generally been in the past something that's difficult to use, expensive, and not available to the majority of organisations. What we've done with AISM Neuro, we've looked at this technology, we've identified a facial recognition software which is affordable, simple to use, and can be applied across a wide range of industries. That includes government bodies, hospitals, licensed venues like clubs, hotels. While most other facial recognition technologies work only when the person's face is uncovered, AISM Neuro goes further. Using a reference image as a starting point, it can ID the person with just half their face being visible. Security and privacy are the things that Neuro holds near and dear. We've looked at our software and we've identified ways of maximising the way we can ensure privacy in the application of this program. We've got the capability of having a watch list, the software only identifying that watch list, and the capability of pixelating everyone else. Furthermore, we don't save images. Everything that's saved within this system is based off an algorithm and cannot be reproduced. The key element for facial recognition is for businesses to be able to ensure the safety of their staff, the safety of their clients, their assets, their buildings. It's the application of being able to identify people quickly that you have on a target list, preventing whether it be somebody that's excluded themselves from a licensed premises for gambling reasons, whether it's somebody that's made threats against one of your staff members. It's not only applied to businesses, but to government agencies, whether it be in airports, where you have a high risk of terrorist attacks. And the whole purpose behind it is to ensure safety and compliance, to minimise risk and harm to individuals.